السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد آج کا سبق سن لیجئے.
Let us listen to the آج کا سبق which is delivered daily by Hazrat Morana Muhammad Yunus the son of Hazrat Morana Muhammad Umar Palanpuri rahmatullahi alayh.
Lesson number 865. Hazrat Anas radiallahu anhu says, I was at the age of 8 when I was given to the khidmat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. I served Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam for a period of 10 years. Whenever I was in the house of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam and there was any difficulty or harm or any untoward condition that happened, then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam would never scold me or he would never shout me. And he would tell the people as well that do not shout Anas, it was meant to happen and hence it happened. This hadith is made mention of in Musabi'u Sunnah. For us to understand and put into perspective this hadith, we have many people working under us in the homes, they are domestics, they are people that are working, and it happens that perhaps they might be doing something that is incorrect, or they might have done something which caused a little bit of harm. Do not shout them, do not scold them. They are human beings as we are human beings. And perhaps we are the owners or we are running the house and paying the salary, and those people, they the workers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us, Allah created them. So we should not get overly angry with such a people. Anas radiallahu anhu says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would never get angry with me. Yes, the most that would happen is he would remind me of my chores, me being a young sahabi. It so happened that once Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had sent me to do a particular chore. It would have taken perhaps 10 minutes to do something. But as I was going and I seen people playing, and I started playing with them. And it took a while and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then after came looking for me. And when he saw me, he asked, O Anas, the work that I have sent you for, has it been accomplished? I said, O Nabi of Allah, I am going now immediately to do that work. So there wasn't any shouting or any scolding, but rather there was a conscious awareness of the responsibility of an individual. And that is how we should try and interact with our people and our domestics at home. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding. We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save this ummah from the punishment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends to people. Allah looks after this ummah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saves us from our own carnal desires and the devil himself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spread his cloth of peace on this ummah. Now read with me. Allahumma ahsin aqibatana fil umuri kulliha وأجرنا من خزي الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة. The hadith makes mention, if any person reads this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saves him from the trials and the tribulations in his life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. Ameen, ameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.